Hi, I'm Derek with Wave Central, here to help you set up your cineVue wireless camera system for the first time. When you receive a system like this from Wave Central, you should know that it's gone through an extensive quality control process to ensure that the kit is working as a complete system end to end. So when you receive it, it should be ready to go right out of the box. Let's start by identifying some of the main components of the system. First is the cineVue microtransmitter, or MCTX. It has a compact form factor, 100 milliwatts max RF output, and operates in the 5.8 gigahertz license-free band on fixed frequencies. Next is the 6DBI Flex omnidirectional transmit antenna. It has a robust end connector, good output gain, and has a flexible spring at its base. The microtransmitter comes with two included power cable options. First is a 4-pin XLR to 2-pin LiMo, and second is a PTAP to 2-pin LiMo. Both of these are great options to have for different power situations in the field. Next up, the cineVue QDR Quick Deploy Receiver. It has two-way diversity reception, does maximum ratio combining between the two antennas, and is really simple to set up and use. An important part of the receive component are the 12 dBi compact sector directional antennas. They are high gain and directional, so that means they're able to pull in the transmitter's RF from a good distance away. Also included with the QDR receiver is an AC power supply. This is for when there's power available and you don't want to use a battery. The first thing you're going to want to do is securely mount the cineVue microtransmitter and the QDR, using the 1/4-20 mounting points on both units. We make these connections part of the design to give you maximum flexibility when mounting the units in the field. You can also use a battery plate configuration like the one I have here to mount the QDR using a 5/8 baby pin stud. Next, we'll attach the transmit and receive antennas to the system. Good RF practice is to always attach an antenna to a transmitter before you turn it on. Why do you want to do that? Well, if you don't, think about it. The RF energy's got no place to go other than back into the transmitter. And that can cause some real damage to the RF modulator, and you don't want to do that. So we attach the 6DBI Omni antenna that emits a pattern much like a donut, 360 degrees, around the outside of the antenna. The compact sector receive antennas attach a little bit differently. They have an N female connector on the bottom, so we need to use these N male barrels to attach them to the QDR receiver. While these may look like Omni antennas, they are actually sectors. So they see a sector of space about 110 degrees wide. You can see that indicated on the front here. There's a front and a left and a right on both of these antennas. So they see a sector of space that's 110 degrees wide, 18 degrees up, and 18 degrees down. You want to keep that in mind as you orient these and the receiver towards the transmitter. Next, connect your HDSDI video input cable to the 3G output of your camera, and then to the video input connector on the microtransmitter. Note that it's the bottom spigot. The top HDSDI connector is a direct loop throw. The cineVue QDR receiver here has two HDSDI spigots on the bottom. We're going to connect to the first one, which is HDSDI only. The second one's kind of unique because you can configure it to be either HDSDI or ASI output to feed an external decoder. That can be switched on via the unit's web GUI. We'll connect the other end of our cable to the confidence monitor. Now that we've attached antennas and video cables to both sides of the cineVue system, it's now time to connect power. And in this case, for the transmitter, I'm using the PTAP to 2-pin LiMo power cable. And then I'm gonna plug that in to the port here on the side of the micro. And then we're gonna supply the power from the Anton Bauer gold mount that's on the back of the C500. You have a couple of different options to power the QDR receiver. The first is with a traditional camera battery, on the Anton Bauer Gold Mount here, or Sony V Mount, should you order it that way. That's the first option. The second option is going to be to use the supplied 12 volt power supply. Plugs into the wall and has a 2-pin LiMo on the bottom supplying 12 volts to the unit here. The QDR receiver and cineVue microtransmitter can both accept between 9 and 36 volts DC in. That's especially helpful in situations where you might run into 24 or 28. These units can accept those higher voltages. As we power on the QDR, just know that it'll take about 20 seconds for it to get to the main information screen. Note the current frequency. In this case, it's 5840 megahertz. Once you're here on the main screen, I want you to click the down arrow button once. That'll take you to the signal level screen. What we're looking for here is to see if anyone's transmitting on your frequency. If you see values that are constant in the -98 to 102 range with no fluctuations, you'll know that the frequency is quiet and okay to use. If you do see some fluctuations here or some signal level bars, you're definitely going to want to relocate frequency, and I can show you how to do that by adjusting the unit's preset. So in order to change the preset on the QDR receiver, all we need to do is start by pressing this top button, which is the Enter key. Click down 2 clicks to preset, press Enter again. You can see that the current preset is preset 10. We're going to highlight that by pressing Enter, so it highlights the number. And we're going to click up 2 clicks to relocate to preset 8. To execute, we'll press Enter. It updates. Now when we press the lower key, the escape key, twice, it takes us back to the main screen. And you can see now we've changed the receive frequency to 5820 megahertz. You're going to follow these same steps with the microtransmitter to ensure that both radios' frequencies match. Since we're not seeing any interfering signals here on the QDR, we're going to go ahead and power on the cineVue microtransmitter. Again, it'll take it about 15 to 20 seconds for it to fully initialize. And then once it does, you'll see the current transmit frequency, which in this case is 5820 megahertz, as well as the fact that RF is on. Another indicator that you're actually transmitting is this green LED that's right next to the transmit antenna. Once the video locks up, you'll notice that both LEDs will turn green. It's happy. It's seeing video. The top light indicates that power is present. The lower light indicates that video is locked. The format and frame rate being supplied will be indicated in the lower line of the front panel. Now have a look at your QDR receiver. Is it happy too? Are you seeing two green lights, one behind the enter key and one behind the escape key? If you are, it's got video lock as well. Then you should be seeing your camera image here on the receive monitor. I really hope this video has been helpful to you as you set up your cineVue system for the first time. I know it's a lot to remember, but like anything, once you've done it a couple of times, it'll become second nature, I promise. I'll go over manually configuring presets along with connecting to the QDR's web GUI, as well as some other helpful tips and tricks in some upcoming videos, so you'll want to be on the lookout for those. In the meantime, leave your questions, your comments, any feedback below, and I'll do my best to get back in touch with you. Thank you so much for watching, and keep creating great work.